Love all.
Pace right out
one,
the gates.
No.
Attack into the middle. Now with a taller opponent on the other side of the table, Shin Yubin will be looking to hit right there into the elbow to jam Sophia up. Long no. serve and the angles to follow. Quick business for Shin Yubin to convert her second serve. The timing out in front. Shin Yubin taller than most, just not taller than her opponent.
One, two.
Both players getting in with the fast long serves and the angles to the corners. In the women's game, we see a lot more backhand to backhand action. Because the women's game tends to be closer to the table, more about speed than spin or power. Ooh, back two. Edge of the table oh. to tie it up. Remember, these two have never played before internationally. So whoever wins this match will not only move on to the round of 16, but will have a 100% win rate and be undefeated against their opponent.
Two, three.
Nice receive here. Polkanova quick on that baseline bounce. At this level, it's far more common to see half-long serves, something that's likely to bounce a second time at the baseline or come close to. It was a good
four,
example.
Two.
And a nice long push here. Polkanova quick on the receive to decide, takes it right off the bounce. Originally from Moldova. He's been playing for Austria for a long time. Actually had a chance to play against one of her young practice partners from Moldova. 4-2 out of the first towel break.
Five.
Good save, but not much to be done here. Polkanova looking as sorry as you could look after winning a point. Wasn't match point, but got the break off the net, sets it up well, converts to finish. Ooh,
two,
deep corner.
Six.
We talk about agility in table tennis. People often want to know what muscles are the most important for professionals. Legs have to be strong, core has to be strong. Lower back is doing a lot of work as well. The twist for every shot here.
Three, six.
The big point here for Shin Yubin in front of the home crowd. Now when we talk about pressure in an Olympic year, the pressure is higher than ever. The top three Korean players by world ranking, if three are inside the top 30 in the world, they will all automatically qualify for their team.
6-4.
And right now, that is Shin Yubin, Chun Ji-hee, and Kim Na-young. But Shin Yubin has extra pressure. The pressure is to take home a medal of some sort from Paris this summer. Reverse pendulum serve, one of the more difficult serves in the game. Polkanova doing it well there. In the cave, right out of the pocket, spinning around the outside of the ball. Clever combination, but a solid opening here. And when I say combination, I mean the two serve set. That appears to be underspin and side spin. Shin Yubin raising up, lifting the ball to keep it out of the net and drive it. 2-point game now. Coach's corner active as can be. Right into
six,
the middle, Shin
seven.
Yubin on a massive streak here in the first. She was trailing 2-6. Half long serve, gets a baseline shot. It looked like she had been expecting it for weeks.
Seven.
Clever use of the table, in and out. Shin Yubin playing slightly more shallow after going baseline. Constant variation in the placement, and that more shallow one begged the question, should I move in? Should I lunge forward?
Seven,
as solid as
eight.
Can be on the receive, and Shin Yubin in front now, after what was appearing to be quite a one-sided start to this match. Right into that middle. Bigger strike zone there for Polkanova.
Eight all.
A much needed point to level the playing field. We've had a lot of five gamers today. Remember, only the top 32 women in the world qualify to be here. In the absence of one, the next in line would step up gladly. Drilling it at the elbow once again. Xin Yubin staying in control. As soon as the rally opens, she's got the racket high, but drops, gets these full strokes in wherever she can. Keeping the power and the pressure on. Second serve, big one here for Xin Yubin. And an ace. This curvy serve swerves past the elbow. Take another look. Pendulum, fast, long, and low. A racing serve sets up two game points for the 19-year-old Xin Yubin. And she takes the game. These shots, I'm shaking my head with disbelief that a player can play both of these shots back to back, right off the bounce, as short of a stroke as can be, and still adding topspin with the placement.
Set. Love one.
And a good deep push. The long push, I feel, is an unsung hero in table tennis. It's not a glamorous shot, but it can be a very divisive tool when used effectively. 2 points on the receive for Xin Yubin to continue her momentum. Shallow, but out in front, using the wingspan to reach and take it early. Very flexible with the wrist. Look at that. Leans forward, gets the reach. Polkanova with a beautiful execution of that backhand.
Two.
They've each had their share of edge shots. Sophia's been through her injuries over the years. Many women in the game have surgeries, physical therapy, time out of the game. Oh, this is too fast. Keeping herself fired up here. Bit of self-motivation. Now, the serve appeared to be heavy underspin, but there wasn't so much underspin on it. It's part of the reason she got the third ball she wanted. Slow and spinny down the middle. Polkanova, four of the first six. And at the towel break, they come up every 6 points. You'll see players from time to time wiping their hands on the table, typically in near the net. And why play it at someone's elbow? Well, they have to really shift and move to create a more comfortable shot. That costs some time, reduces the quality of their shot, and gets them off balance for the next.
2 points.
6-2 wasn't enough in game number one. Keeping a grip on that steering wheel here mentally. How to shut down Xin Yubin. It's five in a row for Polkanova after the first two were taken against her on her serve.
Point.
Now, in the women's game, we see more backhand strokes because the forehand stroke takes so long to recover from, especially for a taller player. And the women's game is the faster game, more about the speed and placement. Ooh, that's tough for Polkanova. Sets it up well, buys herself some good time for that full stroke forehand. Xin Yubin off balance on 1 foot, stays in the point. Keeps it baseline. Huh. 1 point game now after two in a row for Xin Yubin.
Yeah, 4-6.
You can feel the pressure. On the opening shot, Polkanova plays a spinnier, slower, safer shot. And she realizes if she's going to step around and attack the next ball, she's going to be out of position. So she better play it fast and try to finish. Down by two, Shin Yubin. Ooh, surprise, surprise. Six. Fading flick to the forehand. Remember, each player has one timeout in this match. Both of them still have theirs to call. Change of placement here on the serve for Shin Yubin. That long serve and the follow-up. It's not just having a good long serve, it's keeping it well disguised. Until the point of contact, you can barely tell what's going to happen. It could be anything. Tied up now, 6 points apiece. Smart play.
Six,
Shin Yubin been recognizing the opponent on the move and hits it right into the body to jam up the momentum. One to the backhand, and as Sophia shuffles the feet. Well, their fair share of streakiness, I would say, their momentum.
Seven,
good placement on the serve. Asking for the backhand opening flick. Brings in Shin Yubin to an uncomfortable place. 7 points apiece. Behind the table, the spin pays off. When she's got time, Sofia Polkanova's got so much racket speed.
Eight.
The shovel serve with a bit of kick on it. That second bounce makes it jump the top spin. Take a look. Top side accelerates in a surprising way. Even at the professional level, you'll get the edge out of the opponent.
Eight.
Heavy spin point. Coming in. Shin Yubin, two away from the win. Deep spin. Baseline just passed. Eight serving nine. Shin Yubin, as clean as can be on this opening, is looking more and more calculated and precise in her game. Set up for the push, quickly realized it was coming off the table, dropped the racket for the opening attack, and now she's got 2 game points. That forehand so strong. Polkanova not moving early, waiting patiently, taking her step, covers the middle perfectly with the forehand to save a game point. Second serve, Shin Yubin moves to the middle of the table to serve. Break off the net here for Polkanova as she saves another game point. Opening backhand. The crowd gets behind Shin Yubin. Alternating serves until one player has a 2-point lead to take the game. Long push sets up a game point. Sofia Polkanova was down 8-10, and she's won the last 3 points in a row. Two off the
11,
net. Curious what it was that she said here. Two.
11,
My lip read there might have been as good as yours if you don't speak German. Deuce once again. Net and out.
12, 11.
Game point back to Shin Yubin. Looking for that 2-0 start here. The level of play between these two. Shin Yubin has done a wonderful job of making it uncomfortable for Sofia Polkanova. Game point again to the young Korean star. Ooh, the arcing spin shot. It feels dangerous when you fly directly into the storm, but if you do it well prepared and you know the type of storm you're dealing with, precision in the placement secures the point for Polkanova. Fourth towel break, the only score possible. Back to deuce. Top of the net and out.
12.
As close as can be, Shin Yubin looks back at her coach and calls the timeout. Let's go. No! 14, comes over 12, the net in an outright service Shin point. Yubin. She catches.
One love.
Interesting, interesting. Shovel serve. Drive there by Shin Yubin.
Love, two.
The reason I said interesting is it felt like in the previous point the final shot clipped the net on the way over, but different camera angles sometimes give you different, well, pretty much always give you different perspectives. 2 points to start it off. Shin Yubin converts both of her serves.
One, two.
Leaping forward to catch it at its peak before it dips once again. Sofia Polkanova out in front, a little bit into the elbow. It's interesting to see how different players' careers sort of arc over time. Shin Yubin, as you know, young, turned pro at 10 years old and is only 19 now as the leading player for the Korean women. Looking fluid.
Three,
just raises the thumb on the backhand side of the racket to generate a little bit more power. Can see the subtle shift there between the forehand and backhand grip. Little off
Three,
the top of the net on this one. Finger raised only briefly, acknowledging it, but I think just sort of keeping up with the times, it seemed. Tough to cover that elbow. Again, the midsection, taller players tend to use their backhands a little bit more to cover that elbow, just because it's the more efficient stroke, keeps them in position.
Four,
fast long serve
three.
To the backhand, and it's a reverse pendulum. Almost the opposite of the bottle challenge serve, but from and to the same place.
Three,
on top
four.
Of the bounce, controlling with a closed racket, keeping herself calm right now. Ready for the forehands where she can to turn. The more powerful the two strokes, but the costlier one if it comes back. A lot of
four,
rotation on the
five.
Shot coming in. Shin Yubin doesn't blink, doesn't seem bothered at all. Winner of this match will be battling against Bruna Takahashi.
Six, four.
There are no easy matches here. Again, only the top 32 women qualified to be here.
Six, five.
1 point game. I've been impressed with both players, but Shin Yubin under pressure. I think the pressure was the main thing I was thinking about with the Olympics coming up as the team leader.
5-7.
Second towel break, the question of how do you continue getting better? Table tennis as an adversarial sport isn't just about how you practice. It's how you perform against different opponents. It's adapting to what is present the danger on the other side of the table, the unique skill sets of this individual opponent right now.
Time. 6-7.
And trying to flick out Volkanova, but it's Shin Yubin with the tight serve and the point. A lot of redirecting out here, holding that backhand high like a shield. Sofia Polkanova never really getting a chance, but not needing the opportunity for a big stroke. Keeping the gloves high once again and blocking the weapons coming in. Fighting, they say. Chant you can cheer for your Korean favorites. Oh, this receive is too good. Inside the table, stealing the attack. Shin Yubin tightening up the score line once again. Perfect read. In the blink of an eye, the ball's at the baseline. Gotta love these rallies. It's Polkanova with three game points now. Adding the spin and the speed. Behind the table, the arc on that ball is tough to deal with. Shin Yubin fighting.
11.
And the wide forehand covered with the wide wingspan and the fast feet. China produces many of the best in the world. Even Korea's number two, Jun Ji-hee, born and raised in China, has been playing very well for Korea over the last several years now. It's been quite some time.
Two.
Feels like about a decade for that matter, maybe 12 years now. So momentum continuing. The Moldovan Austrian on screen, Sofia Polkanova. A lot of work for a point, but it's the spin play, the arcing shots here. Now, when you are as tall as Sofia Polkanova is, you can survive a step behind the table. In some senses, you almost need the time. Seven of the last 8 points have worked out in the Austrians' favor, and that's not a coincidence. Nice placement into the middle. Handling the side spin coming in, and Shin Yubin on the scoreboard now. Very awkward ball bending from the elbow to the other side of the elbow out to the forehand.
Four.
Smart combination. Short to the backhand, wide deep to the forehand. If you were to draw a line between the bounces of the last two shots on Shin Yubin's side, it's one of the greatest distances you could imagine here.
2-4.
It tends to even out over time, but it feels like Shin Yubin has had far more nets than Sofia Polkanova here. The low trajectory. I think that's partially the difference. It's a big part of it. Sofia Polkanova's game has been a lot more arcing spin shots.
Set. 2-4.
Pressure inside the table. Shin Yubin following her serve well. If there were timeouts left, you'd probably hear one right about now. But finding ways to pin that middle to make the blocking game less comfortable for Polkanova. Oh, the ripping backhand, confident. Hesitation, zero. Sofia Polkanova, one more time. clean swing, gets ready to turn should the ball come back for a combination forehand follow-up. Bottle challenge serve, cleverly placed right back into the elbow. Shin Yubin knew what she was doing. Didn't have a lot of time to respond that way, but still managed to generate a quality receive. 1 point game. And now it is tied up. Tie game at 5-5. Long push, but right in position, Shin Yubin. Did not compromise her stance. Was able to get the full stroke she needed in. Level now at 5-5. This is how you construct a point.
6.
Blocking with the racket high, adding topspin where she can, and as soon as the time is allowed to turn for the forehand, she never lets go. Volkanova taking over control of the spin rally, getting back in front by 1.
Seven.
Loaded with underspin, a digging push. Remember the push, the underspin shot from inside the table. A little bit shorter stroke than a chop. Opening flick. This is the big rally before, the demonstration. Now from this camera angle, it looks like Sofia Polkanova is quite relaxed there. Not going for broke, playing the spin game.
8 points.
Tight serve sets up a 3-point lead and a silent shaking fist of celebration. Bit of encouragement for the relatively veteran player out here.
Nine.
Cashing in 1 IOU off the top of the net. Polkanova. Back. Some parallel play here. Shin Yubin with 1. And the second one just crossing the H's there. Painting the parallels, maybe a better way. Ooh.
10-6.
Looking for an inside out forehand. Seems to catch the hand possibly and carry off. Looked like it caught the thumb. Boop. 4 game points for Polkanova. Oh,
10,
but not so
7.
Fast as Shin Yubin. Guides it right back to the opposite corner. 1 game point saved, 3 more to go. Long push to the baseline, and a beautiful follow-up. Down the middle, we are 7. Going to the D, to the side, to the dir. Looking to take back what she started. Shin Yubin. Step around in the inside out forehand. You can feel the intensity in the room right now, the pressure to convert here in game 5. Taking the full risk here to step around and leave the whole table open to hit that winner. And it pays off.
Left. 1. Low.
And the grunts and the timing, changing the rhythm. Polkanova, keep your eyes on it. A little more shallow on that last one. A little bit less topspin as well. Slow and spinny, shallow this time around. The spin shot. Sofia Polkanova keeping it uncomfortable. Shin Yubin has been quite strong from the start. She's playing the speed game well.
1-3.
And on the other side, there's something so exciting to see the fire in both of these women as they battle out here. how long and fast that fist shakes. It's a quiet celebration because it's not over yet.
Two, three.
Catches the net clamp right near the microphone. In table tennis, the net clamp is considered part of the net assembly, so if it hits even just barely above the table, comes down on the other side. Still good.
4-2.
First towel break, trying to will her way through. Remember those points we saw on the chart? 15 right now, but it quickly rises. And they will switch sides as one player has reached 5 points in the deciding game. Sofia Polkanova with that reverse pendulum serve. She's moved it around the table so well. We've seen her play it to a wide variety of spots. The forehand short, the backhand deep in there, to the shorter side of half long on the backhand. This was a big point. That's the loudest roar that we have heard from Sofia Polkanova this match. The momentum swing here is pretty massive. And a 4-point lead, the pressure put on Shin Yubin right now is more than she's had this match. Back edge of the table to continue. Polkanova, 7-2 she leads. Again, you can feel how genuine this apology is. That's what it looks like when the ball catches the edge of the table. Virtually no chance in real time to adjust. 12 of the last 16 to Polkanova.
2-7.
Much needed point, Shin Yubin. You can feel the tension and the muscles tightening up. Easier said than done to stay loose. I think anyone who's ever gone to the gym knows what this is like when you start to hit your limits. You slow down, your reps become that much more of a struggle. And Shin Yubin finding ways. Just sometimes a second wind comes out when you need it, whether it's adrenaline, will, or a deep breath that frees your mind and frees up the tension in your muscles. 3 points between them now. Yeah! Quick backhand counter, and it's 4 points once again. Polkanova in her first encounter is playing this match like she has a lot to settle here. You would think there was a history between these two. Like Shin Yubin had won their last 7 encounters or something. Or did something to a family member of Sofia Polkanova, the way she's roared. It's simply the desire to win here. Spinning in deep, 2 points away. She was down 0-2, Sofia Polkanova. 1 game away from elimination. And then she took the last two, 11-7, and now 5 points up. Shin Yubin in a tough position here. Crushing forehand, sets it up, gets her opponent way behind the table. And even with the steps of Polkanova, there's just too much ground to cover. The lob was shallow, so Shin Yubin was able to play the angle, hit it to the forehand out of reach. Match points. Started from 0-0, then 0-2, and now she's here. Drake's first draft, 10 serving 5. Oh, the dribbler, the fortune comes back against Shin Yubin. She had the IOUs to cash in the timing.